Let's say that I run some type of a pension fund, and I have $1 billion that I need to invest someplace. And I dig around a little bit, and there's this company A over here, and it needs to borrow $1 billion, and it's willing to give 10% interest in exchange for borrowing that $1 billion. So if I give these characters over here my $1 billion, if I lend it to them, if I lend them the $1 billion on an annual basis, they are going to give me 10% interest. There's a problem here, though. The rating agencies, the ones that in theory should be independent, they've only given Company A a double B rating. And this is a pension fund. I have to only invest in the safest of securities. I have to invest only in things that are double A. And so here might enter a character like AIG. And obviously, things have changed since their heyday. But AIG, based on at least Moody's perspective, it has a double A rating. So AIG could say, hey, look, pension fund, why don't you lend them the money? And what we're going to do is enter into a credit default swap. And what that essentially is a form of insurance. Of that 10% every year, why don't you give us 1% of that? And in financial lingo, that's sometimes referred to as 100 basis points. And in exchange for that 100 basis points a year, you can view this as the insurance premium, we are going to ensure that if for whatever reason company A defaults on that debt, you can give us the debt, you can give us that debt security, and we will just give you back your $1 billion. Now, from the pension's point of view, this sounds pretty good. They're now getting a net 9% of interest, 10% minus the 1%. And they're essentially getting to lend to a double B company, but it's in effect like lending to a double A. Because as long as AIG is good for the money, then the pension fund is going to get their money back one way or the other. Now, where this gets a little bit shady is AIG right here didn't have to do anything. What's interesting about credit default swaps, sometimes referred to as CDSs, is that even though they are insurance, for all purposes, they are insurance, they are not regulated like insurance. So typically, an insurance company, when they insure something, they have to set aside some money in case that thing actually happens. And they have to work out the probabilities and all that. The credit default swaps were not regulated in that way. So AIG could do this without having to set aside any type of money. And they could do this over and over and over and over again, kind of snowballing all of their potential liabilities. And so you can imagine, it's really good money while no one is defaulting, but all of a sudden when people start defaulting, then all of a sudden AIG is going to be in trouble, and all the people who thought they had, in effect, double A debt because AIG was insuring it, might not.